Hello everyone. It's been some time since my last video, and I wanted to start, get the ball rolling right away. I realized I completed Breath of the Wild, Zelda Breath of the Wild, a month or something. I don't remember when I cleared not the whole game, I just did the story. I don't remember now, a month or a month and a half ago, and I never made a video following up on my thoughts. Instead of going on the whole, like, oh, what's so great about it, like, there's, like, probably thousands of videos praising its gloriousness, how amazing is Breath of the Wild, it's so perfect, it's fantastic, 10 out of 10s, some 9s out of 10s, okay, obviously it's a great game, I do not disagree with that, I agree it's a great game, but nothing is perfect in my opinion, and, I'm just going to talk about the things that I felt were flawed with it. How dare you? How dare you talk about such a magnificent production, a work of divine mastery? How dare you put any blemish? Take this video down. Remove it from the history books. Yes, there are some flaws, in my opinion. These are my opinions. Let me say again, I loved that game. It was amazing. It was fantastic. It was great, but I don't want to repeat what millions of YouTubers have probably already said, which is how great it was, you know? So I'm going to talk about the things that I felt were missing. Here's a few of them, but there's only one really that, like, I felt like if they had it, I would have been like, wow. Okay, number one, people like the story. I like the story. Zeldas aren't really known for their stories. Like, they have good, okay stories, but that's not the main focus. This one, in my opinion, was okay, but it felt, due to the nature of the game, it felt disjointed. Like, you're gaining most of your story of this game through your memories. Try not to give any spoilers away, so. And your relationship with Zelda, who's like you're the main character, Link, and then she's like the main feminine, whatever, she's the princess. It's mainly through memories and sometimes through, like, this telepathic link that she has going on with you because she's somewhere else doing something. Don't want to spoil it. But if you're watching this, you probably already know how the story goes anyway. I felt that you could have been written, like, not totally differently, but there could have been a slight differences. She could have physically been there with you along the way, you know? I felt would have built more of a rapport and more of a relationship in that way instead of these memories where if you don't get them in the right order, you have to eventually watch them in the right order. And it is kind of cool seeing how she like kind of hates you and then likes you or whatever. But I felt like your events in this game, what you're doing, don't impact that relationship very much until the end. And, you know, that could have been something, in my opinion, that would have been better. Also, the other champions are also through their memories for other reasons, and through like other forms, but I don't know, that could have been done slightly differently. I feel like this is this person's memory story slash interaction with you. Now, once you complete that, because this is an open world game, done. Same thing, like there's four, whatever. Okay, that's my problem with the story, not so much the story, but how the story is presented. I don't know the answer to that problem. Next thing is the dungeons, okay? This Zelda, Breath of the Wild, has two forms of dungeons. You have your shrines, which are like mini dungeon puzzles, and there's like 100 and something of them. I'm talking about the core Breath of the Wild game, not the DLC or whatever. I haven't even played that yet. But yeah, so you have all these shrines, right? Instead of major dungeons, you have shrines all over the world and you have to unlock them, and then every time you beat four of them you can upgrade your health or your stamina. They are the Zelda form of grinding, and you do get a lot of rewards within the shrines as well. You get different pieces of armor, different weapons, whatever, and then you get this crazy, like, the armor of the what? I don't know, I haven't even done the full shrine quest, to be honest with you. That's great. I like it. Don't take that away. That's not what I'm saying. And then you have your ancient beasts, which is there's four of them. Spoiler alert. And those are supposed to be what would be the main dungeons of the game, but they're not like the typical Zelda dungeons that we have experienced in the past. Number one, you can do them in any order. I don't know, people love this open world, we can do however we want, yay! But if I went to like the camel, if people understand what I'm saying, if I went there first, what was I gonna do? Realistically, against a freaking thunder guy, anyway. And also, they don't feel interconnected. Although they were like the four generals of this ancient army, they don't feel connected to one another because they each have their own segment, and due to its open world nature, it's hard to make a story that builds upon one another because of this, like, you can do them at any time. I like the option of that, I like that. However, storytelling does lack, and I don't know, you can argue with me if you want, but in that sense, storytelling lacks. But I don't even have a problem with that, and I don't have a problem with the ancient beasts themselves. Keep those in the game. But they didn't feel like a real dungeon. Nothing felt like I'm in a dungeon right now. Like the old Zelda games. Is that a problem? Not necessarily, but like, they were more thematic based on the area of the map that you were in Zelda. Like, you had your fire area, desert one, whatever, right? And it's like, you're just in this mechanical robot thing, which is, I have no problem with those being in the game how they were, but like, there's no area that like says, I'm in this area and there's this big challenge in this area, like, because it's a, I don't know, like a snow temple or a fire temple. I'm just saying temple names based on old games, but something of that nature. I don't know, that's not a big problem for me, but like, I miss that. But here's the biggest problem for me. The biggest complaint that I have with Breath of the Wild. Everybody loves, oh, I got the tablet in the beginning of the Ishika Stone in the beginning of the game, and I got all the apps, like the magnet thing and all the power-ups right away, so I could do whatever I want. But then, as you're going through the game, there's nothing, you can only upgrade them to do like a little bit of extra things, but there's nothing, like, how do I explain this? You can go anywhere you want from the beginning of the game. That's a good thing, but like, I feel like I could have accomplished more, and like, not just because I have to go get a set of armor to withstand the heat or to withstand the cold or whatever. That's like a cop out, in my opinion. I like the idea of like the world kind of opening up, not linear, but like you start in the center, but like maybe like I can only go to these parts because I don't have things that I can get to other parts. And I like the idea of the world opening up, it, but not in a linear way, but like chunks of it. Not like you can only go here, you can only go here, you can only go here. And it doesn't necessarily have to be through the dungeon items how they used to have it. But like, a good example is like when I finished three Zelda games after I beat Breath of the Wild just to get like a refresher. I refinished Ocarina of Time, Link Between Worlds, and the Link's Awakening, which is the Game Boy one. Link Between Worlds kind of was like, the idea was used in Breath of the Wild. You can get the items right away. Again, I love that game, but I felt like lacking because I like the idea of, I can't go here yet, but this thing's right there, but like, I want to be able to get there, so I gotta figure out what I need to get there. And then like, you don't have that in Breath of the Wild or Link Between Worlds because it's like, oh, within a few rounds, of a few hours of the game, you can do anything you want. So then on that note, like when I played Link's Awakening, what I noticed, I remembered it, but like I hadn't played it for years since I was a child. It was the first Zelda game I actually ever beat. But when I played Link's Awakening, what I noticed playing it again is, they give you, when you start the game, you can only get so far with what you have. And then each time you clear a dungeon and get their item, more of the overworld unlocks. Like, in the sense of, like, you couldn't get somewhere because you couldn't jump before. But then you get an item that lets you jump, and now I can jump over things and get further. Or I need to lift heavy rocks, so I get a bracelet, and now I can go even further. Or these, like, there's water and I can't swim, so I can get flippers, and then I can go even further. That's the feeling I would have liked to have experienced in Breath of the Wild. To like a certain extent. I guess because the magnitude and the scope of the game, they captured everything perfectly, but if they could somehow hybrid the two, like, the formula with this open world idea, going back to the first Zelda and Breath of the Wild, if they could kind of hybrid and mash that up, it'd be very difficult, but if they could pull that off, I think it'd be a great game. So that's really my only complaint, not even a complaint, like, I don't feel the game suffered, like, I don't feel the game is bad in any way, I feel it was great, but I missed that. I guess that feeling of like, yes, I got this, now I can do more. I got that in other ways in the game, like you get stronger and you level up, or you get more health or better armor. But I still felt like, oh, the hook shot or I don't know. Now I'm drawing a blank. Power bracelet, whatever, you know. Those things would have been like, oh, now I can go further. Anyway, other than that, great game. The final boss, I have no spoilers, but it was kind of meh in my opinion, but I'll let that slide, because it could really depends on how you want to beat the game. You can make it really difficult for yourself, or you can make it really easy for yourself. So yeah, that being said, Breath of the Wild, great game. Again, these are just my opinions of what I felt was missing and I would have liked to have seen. And that's all I have to say. If you like this video, please like. Please subscribe and have a great day. Thanks for watching.